Hi Gemini, thanks for stopping in and checking this channel out, checking this tarot reading out. Want to say a special what's up to all the people that have shown me support and love. I really appreciate it. I think in February this channel made $7.46. So that's plenty for me and I couldn't have done it without you. So thanks Gemini, I really appreciate it. We're going to be looking at a mid-March checkup, so to speak. We're going to be looking at the messages for Gemini for the last 2 weeks of March 2017. Messages for Gemini in the last 2 weeks of March 2017. Okay, Gemini, I hope you're all well. I hope you're all comfortable and in a place of abundance and prosperity in these times. If not, we're going to ask Tarot to reveal hidden messages and to clear up some stuck energies to help us all along the way. Okay, later on in the reading, we're going to pull an Oracle card from the Enchanted Map Oracle deck for a little bit of added direction. I'm going to get these cards centered up here. And at the bottom of the deck, you guys have an Eight of Swords reverse here. So the feeling I have from this here is that some of you might be coming to a point of acceptance about certain things regarding situations or people or even yourself at this time. The Eight of Swords, when it's in an upright position, can speak to somebody who's feeling a little bit trapped by a particular way of thinking or in thought patterns that aren't conducive to progression spiritually, life, or otherwise. When the card comes reversed and in an overall energy situation, it's almost like a new day is dawning in terms of like realizations, thought processes, simple shifts in thinking. So this is kind of like clarity being reattained, or some of you may be accepting help from certain things from outside sources right now and kind of questioning where that's going to lead. So we'll leave this Eight of Swords reversal off to the side here and relate back to it as we work through the seven card chakra spread that we use. Oh, so in a grounding area, we have a Five of Swords straight up. So some of you here, Gemini, are dealing with some, the proverbial BS right off the hop here in your day-to-day life. Some of you may be feeling certain conflicts in the workplaces or in relationships, in social circles that are sort of leading to quarrels and misunderstandings. As well, some of this for some of you could be just like blatant disregard for your feelings here. Somebody might have just a blatant, you know, going for their own agenda and not really caring that, you know, other people are being hurt along the way. I'm sad to see this card in a grounding position for you. The silver lining in this, however, is that whatever's going on is causing you to change your thinking, to shift your views about the people involved, and are going to inevitably lead you into a place of better position and better strength. The Five of Swords left unchecked can really speak to ego, not being aware of you know, the higher self and things of that nature. So I want to make sure whatever it is that's got you guys in a bit of a tizzy in regards to other people, it's not leaving you too detached from your higher self and from spirit at this time. Okay? And if there are certain things here with this Five of Swords and Eight of Swords that are leading you to clarity, it's wanting to make sure that you're analyzing, even though it's bullshit, analyze the bullshit. Kind of like question, what is the cause of it? You know, is it just someone's narcissism, or were there a certain chain of events that led to a point of no return, or like an argument that's taken place so that you can prevent a repeat, kind of, right? Because we never like to have the Five of Swords. So one chakra up in creativity and sacred energy, sacral area, we have the Knight of Cups straight up. So for some of you, this could be a person here. This could be someone you are in a relationship with, potentially a water sign. Someone potentially that could be being a little bit selfish in regards to their setting the schedules. They like connect, you know, when they feel you know, like connecting, and like, you know, when you feel connecting, sometimes they just like don't make you a priority, you know. This person, if this is the person behind this Five of Swords, Eight of Swords feeling, could be someone here as well that's like on their own path and is just seeing you as kind of facilitating in some sort of way, or helping, where your perception of the relationship might be a lot different than theirs. So Knight of Cups there sometimes can be like disillusionment. If you have a lot of water in your charts, Gemini, this could be you want to internalize this court card. This definitely could be you needing to take a stand, being in a position of greater strength, and standing up for yourself in your own right, in your own sense of self here, putting looking out for number one, in that, in these types of situations. To have this card show up in the creative energy, it shows here that some of you could be pouring a lot of emotion and passion into artistic projects at this time. If you are a creative person, you like to let that sense go. It's saying that there's a lot of emotion behind whatever it is that you're painting or creating musically, or whatever it is you're working on. So it could be a good sign here for some of you. All right, and I have cups in the second chakra house. As we move up to gut instinct, we have Two of Wands reversed here. So something's definitely got you guys off your game. You guys are dealing with some external energies, I feel, these 2 weeks, that are leading to situations where you're not knowing where you stand with somebody. You're not really knowing, you're almost placing a little bit much too much value on how other people might be viewing you, and then kind of left in bewilderment because you don't know where you stand with that person. It could be like causing like this mental chaos, or this feeling where it's like you're of uncertainty, right? But the feeling is that you guys are coming out of it. You're getting some clarity on the situation. You're becoming aware of it. But you're not really moving forward at this time. It's almost like you're not in a victimization position, but you're at a point of like sort of acceptance but inactivity. You're almost, it's like some of you are in a position of inaction. You're waiting for the chips to fall. You're waiting for other people to show their cards first. You're waiting for other people to like come clean on situations, and it's leading, like the energy is feeling a little bit stuck here in these bottom three chakras, especially in root and solar plexus. We're going to move along quickly, because what I see here is something that it's not beyond your control. So far, like, it's not the best, like you're dealing with some crap here, but it's not beyond your control from what Tarot is saying. And here we have Nine of Wands reversed, so it continues on with the same energy. We're coming out of being this feeling of being tr feeling trapped, feeling stuck, feeling that, you know, things are beyond your control, but kind of falsely so. It's almost like you could really take the reins of this situation here and ring some things in. Like, you want to just kind of grab some people by the wrist and be like, here, come, look, I want to show you. Like, I want to tell you. I want to, I need you to tell me, like, what's going on here. So this could be, these four cards here, they could be a call to action for you to like be telling some of the people around you to smarten up, or to stop being so kind of like in a gray area or smoky energy. It's almost as if like you've subtly been kind of like you know, accepting the way the people around you have been, and making certain, you know, considerations, so that you're not, you know, stepping on anyone's toes or hurting anyone's feelings, but you're doing so at your own detriment. It's like costing you unneeded energy, unneeded time and effort to do this, where it's like you kind of need to be like, nope, enough is enough. You people need to figure out your own crap, because you're relying on me too much of the time, and I don't have the energy for this anymore, basically, is what we got here. So speak from the heart with that. You don't need to be necessarily be harsh with them, but at the same time, you've got to show them in some way that or communicate to them in some way that, you know, you're done subtly tiptoeing around them for some reason, okay? And when it comes to communication, what we have, We have the moon reverse. So yes, there's definitely need for clarity here. There's too much like guessing game type energies around you, like almost like some like we've got two parties involved here, and like they're both kind of like withholding information, waiting for others to like cave first. So if you're like in negotiations with people at this time, like in a business sense, it might be time to like really get assertive, and like even if you have to show like half of your cards or like come through with like half what you're feeling in order to at least get, some clarity out of the people around you. If you feel you need that to move on, then that's what you've got to do. This moon energy as well could be saying that some of you might really be being tested from the universe right now to speak your truth, to be true to yourself, with the message that you want to convey to other people. It's almost like there could be some risk of like acting or speaking too quickly without being certain of the message that you're wishing to convey. Like I've got a feeling of like heightened tension. It's not anxiety, but there's and it's not really stress, but there's tension here. And it's like it's coming from a misunderstanding. It's coming from not knowing, and it's coming from a lack of information that's being revealed to you, okay? You're unable to move forward at this time, Gemini, because of this. But I want to make sure that you're not in this situation because of others, like or like because of yourself, wholeheartedly, one way or the other. If you're in this situation because of yourself, you need to get direct. You need to get to be clear in your speech and what you're hearing, and make sure that you're not diluting in any way. And if this is in the hands of others, if this misunderstanding and this confusion is in the hands of others, you really gotta like almost present like an ultimatum. Like, yo, like come on, either come clean with me here or get lost. One of the two. Like you can't be spending any more energy on whatever it is this query here is that's brought forward these cards in this reading the way that it has. Here, just because we've got a little bit too much of this trapped feeling, a little bit too much of this disillusionment, sort of this like gray area that I'm seeing here. Nothing is defined clearly in these 2 months, all the way up in through communication. And if the breakthrough is going to occur, it has to be in this house of communication. There's no amount of like thinking or feeling about it that's going to change the situation. This has to be like clear and direct, okay, guys? Okay. Now, as we move up here, oh, look at this. Now we've got the faded card up here in reverse here, in number 12 Hangman, right? If he was like this, it's kind of like the situation is far beyond your control. The fact is like this, it's almost like you need to take a stand to get out of this situation. The growth and the progression is happening all around you, except for where it needs to be, which is like coming through you, right? You're unable to move forward this time, but it's unnecessarily showing this. Like, and card for card has been stacking up of reaffirmation on the same thing time after time. So if you guys want examples or want me to see into your lives, the tarot is being really unclear. The tarot is pretty much saying to me is that whatever this situation is that's going on for you, me as a reader, all I can tell you is that you've got to define it. You've got to clarify it. It's almost like you're coming in here with like a completely blank slate, but you're perceiving this blank slate as being an obstacle, like full of trouble, full of woe, kind of thing. And it all starts off back here with this Five of Swords. Whatever trouble this is that you're dealing with, it's affecting you too heavily, almost too greatly. And now we're into these upper chakras and these higher energies from the major arcana, saying that with the Hangman and the Moon, saying like, whoa, 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 here we've got to get back to the basics. We've got to get back to the basics of life. What we know to be true, what we know to that serves us. We need to fill our lives with those things around you. And it might be so as easy as getting in touch with people that have helped you in the past that can you can rely on versus of like, having forgotten about certain experiences and certain lessons that were learned in the past that you actually could be putting to good use for yourself right now in this current situation that you find yourself in. And for some of you, if this is not resonating so far, if you're like, nah, I'm not really, I don't really have any problems, that's good. That's okay too. These cards here in this case are saying is we need to get a new spark. We need to get feeling, get some feeling behind things right now. I want to say for some of you, there might be a bit of risk of some isolation right now. I want to make sure you guys are going out, being social, find some support through community endeavors, get some common ground with people, commonalities. If you have an interest, let's go out and let's share those things in community right now. Let's not isolate because that could be the situation for some of this confusion and these tense energies here are coming from more of like an isolation and the inner spirit just crying to get out and kind of like a longing for connection. Okay. Wow. These cards are really difficult to see through. I feel like I want clarifiers for all of them, but I'm not the type of reader to ask for too many clarifiers. Look at this. Now we have a Page of Wands reversed coming in. So this is showing even more confusion and missed messages. So whatever this is not clearing up. Source is almost being like, and it's not abandoning you, but it's wanting to show you a lesson. It's wanting you, Gemini, in a way to sort of like snap out of your own funk, show the universe that you have the power to overcome this minimal, this punitive ticky-tacky bullshit that's going on. It's almost like the universe sees you here like playing victim to yourself for whatever it is that's going on, when the universe really wants to say to you here through this Page of Wands reverse, the message in this here is like, smarten up. Like, there's nothing here that you can't overcome. Nothing has been presented to you that you don't have the power to solve in this situation. This reading is really like, take a stand, get the F over it, smarten up, get out the door, start kicking ass and taking names, and everything's gonna be all right. It's when we overthink these things. It's when we perceive that they're beyond our control. And whether it's a feeling, we've got one court cup card here. We've got some wands and we've got some swords here. So this is like, for many of you, this could be queries that are across the board. Whether it's a wife, whether it's a husband, whether it's a sort of a child that hasn't been in touch for a while, whether it's a boss at work, it could be a plethora, a multitude of things here that have got you feeling like stumped, stuck, even downright stooged, like, kind of chasing your own tail in a lot of aspects, Gemini here. We almost need to get out of the dreaminess that, that the universe is going to take care of these situations. To a point it will, but it's not going to unless you define it, you clarify it. For some of you, I'm sorry, I'm kind of like lacking compassion in my readings again. I know, I'm sorry. You guys might have to balance it out with somebody who has a lot of compassion. For me, this is about getting you the help that you need and being able to see into the things that you're not presently witnessing, whether it's about yourself or your situation. Okay? So that's why I come off as a little direct sometimes. And I'm sorry, I don't mean to. What I'm saying here is we've really got to get into some affirmations. Say to yourself, I have the power to move forward from whatever it is that's troubling me. Okay? And also, like, dear universe, dear God, Buddha, Jesus, Muhammad, nothing is going to happen today that you and I can't handle together. All right? That kind of thing. But you have to co-create. You have to co-problem solve. Right? Right now here, this area of creativity is your powerhouse right now. This is the card to say, you gotta get back up on this horse. You have got to be the one that pulls yourself out of this, And being able to effectively problem solve for yourself, right? Some of you might be relying too much on other people's advice, or some of you might have straight up just got bad advice in the not too distant past, and it's really left you like confused and being like, what the heck? Like, this was authentic advice from someone I trusted, and now you're like maybe even a little bit bitter at that person when they were just trying to help unnecessarily so. Or because the message here is like, you gotta get this effective problem solving happening for you. Only you can realize what the depth and the seriousness of your problem is. It's almost like when you lose something and you have to retrace your steps to go and find it. Okay, well, where was the last place I had? And then you go walking through the kitchen, through the bedroom, and eventually you walk back to the place where your last memory of having it was. So we can apply that kind of thinking to whatever it is that's troubling us, Gemini. We can think, okay, well, let's think back to the last time where we really felt good. We really felt awesome. So then we get that memory in our mind. Okay, now what has transpired since that time to bring us into our present day? And we kind of walk ourselves back through it. Okay, well, maybe we interacted with so and so, and so and so was a bitch, or so and so was an asshole. And now, so let's say, okay, well, I'm not much of a different person than the last time when I was feeling really good about myself and my situation. Things around me have changed, but the core of my being hasn't changed. I'm still the same, Linda Lou or Betty Sue or Johnny Johnson. So that's what we kind of have to like get into that finding ourselves almost, retracing our foot. Oh, there we finally got the jumper from the Oracle deck there. You could hear me shuffling them almost forever. And rightly so, like, wow, you guys have had a bit of a tough go, or are being warned to batten down the hatches, because the last 2 weeks in March, they might have you feeling really low and really bummed out for some reason here. And we want to try and minimize the damage that this bummed out feeling is doing. Now, from the Enchanted Map Oracle deck, you guys have pulled number 10, Rock Bottom. I can't make the cards better. I can't make the cards worse. I just pull the cards for what they are. So, number 10, Rock Bottom, and I quote, "Surrender and acceptance are the keys to freedom. As difficult as it might be to accept, it seems you've reached a point where you can go no further in the same manner in which you've been doing things. Perhaps you've hit a proverbial brick wall, or experience a deep sense of loss and don't know where to turn. The old way of doing things must be discarded fully in order to move onward and upward. A new direction and a new strategy are called for. The only way out is through surrender. Accept things as they are and admit that you have no idea what to do next. If you wait in that heartfelt moment of release, then a stairway will appear, like magic. And all manner of synchronicities will show you the way to higher ground. The Rock Bottom card is a sign that a miracle is about to occur, but only if you let go completely." So you hear a lot of readers, you hear a lot of people in these communities of astrology and tarot and New Age saying you have to release, you have to let go, right? And a lot of times it's done to like the nth, right? Like it's like, yeah, we get it. We all know we need to let go. But here in this situation, Gemini, the feeling that I have here is this need to change direction, this need to find yourself. When we're perceiving that we're between a rock and a hard place, or that we've like hit rock bottom, which is why I apologize for not having as much compassion as a reader as I should, like being more empathetic to this situation. But for so many of you watching, and for your situations all being so different, that's difficult for me to be empathic in that way, when all I really want to convey to you through spirit is that when you do find yourself at rock bottom, you've got to find a direction that is going to serve you. And it can't be what you've been doing, because the path you've been on has led you to rock bottom. So that path is over. That path does not continue on anymore. the path that must be taken, and like I said, kind of going back to retracing those footsteps, you could walk backwards along the path that got you there. But a simple change of perspective might also reveal a new path that you could take to sort of get yourself out of it. And you guys are going to be on the verge of that. I'm really glad that this card came up in reverse. Is showing that this is coming to an end, right? It's showing that it's there. This Knight of Cups in sacral energy as well is showing that problem solving, creative and intuitive problem solving is going to be key for this in you, Gemini. I wish the cards were better. You know I love you guys. I'm going to see you again in 2 weeks, and we're going to hope for a better reading, and we're going to look towards that miracle that wants to occur in our life as long as we can facilitate it through our simple paradigm shift in thinking. Okay, Gemini, love you lots. We'll see you soon.